everyone. Welcome back to Teacher in the Park. I am very glad that you were able to join us for week two. Okay, what we're going to do is warm up with some brain teasers. If you joined us last week, we did begin with some fun brain teasers. So we're going to start up here at the top, our very first rectangle. I want you to think of a word that fits each description. So I'll help you out with number one and two. Number one, just think about what comes to mind when you hear the word golden. So when I hear the word golden, I think of a golden ring. So if you are with a sibling or a parent or guardian at home, you can share whatever comes to your mind when you hear or think of the word golden. Or if you just want to think to yourself or write it down, you certainly can. So a word that fits each description. So golden, whatever comes to mind. Number two, slippery. A word that comes to my mind is slippery rock. I know that I enjoy walking my dogs, and a lot of times when it rains or if it's early in the morning, sometimes the grass or the rocks that we near the trails that we walk are often slippery, so we have to be careful. Number three, smooth. What word comes to mind when you think of smooth? I know a word that comes to my mind is peanut butter. I like smooth peanut butter, not the chunky peanut butter with the peanuts in. I know some people prefer that, but I like the smooth, creamy peanut butter. Number four, bumpy. Maybe you prefer that bumpy peanut butter, so peanut butter might come to your mind when you hear bumpy. But what word comes to mind when you hear bumpy? Maybe a toad. Toads have bumps on them. Bumpy toad or bumpy road. First word that comes to mind when you hear bumpy. Number five, multicolored. That's a good one, multicolored. I know when I think of multicolored, I think of stained glass windows. And the last one is fancy. Fancy. And I think of fancy dress, like a cocktail dress that you would wear to a nice dinner. Fancy. So hopefully you had a little bit of fun with that. Let's go down here to Would You Rather. Again, if someone is at home with you, feel free to share. There's no right or wrong answer here. Would you rather have a smoothie or a milkshake? So take about 30 seconds, share out your Would You Rather with somebody near you. And this is a good one. For me, it depends. After the gym or in a hot summer day, I'd prefer a smoothie. But sometimes I just like a chocolate milkshake. So I think it depends. Again, there's no right or wrong answer here. All right, Let's go down here to find the pattern. We're starting with 15. We increase, that means our numbers go up to 30. We then increase again to 45. We increase again to 60. Then again to 75. What would our next number in our pattern be? If you said increase by 15, you are correct. To get from 15 to 30, we need to increase or add 15. To get from 30 to 45, it's another increase of 15. Same thing from 45 to 60, and so on and so forth. So 75 plus 15. Gives us 90. And then 90 plus 15 gives us 105. Okay, a little bit of math for us to get us thinking. Down here, magnetic or not? Just something to think about. Scissors. Are they magnetic or not? How about a Coke can? Do you think a Coke can is magnetic or not? Are staples magnetic or not? Paper clips. Ooh, is a refrigerator magnetic or not? A nickel coin. A dime. And a penny. Good items and objects to think about. If you have any of them at home and you want to experiment with them, that is perfectly fine. I'm not going to give you the answers because some of these are very common items that you may have lying around the house. So if you want to experiment and see if they are magnetic, then you certainly can. So you can have fun and experiment with those different items. Okay, the next one, I'll give you 30 seconds. How many computer parts can you name? This one was tricky when I was putting this together. I actually had to stop and think for a little bit. There's not too many that I know. I know the keyboard and the mouse. And that was pretty much it, but I'll give you some time to think. And see how many parts you can actually name that belong to the computer. Okay, hopefully you did better than I did and were able to name more than two. But if not, that is perfectly okay. And let's move on to the last part of our warm-up here. Again, we have some pictures, and you're going to determine which picture of the shoe is meant for disco dancing. Do you think one, two, or three would be a good shoe for disco dancing? Which shoe is a good shoe for soccer? And which shoe would you wear for hiking? So I'll give you about 30 seconds to make your choice. Which shoe is the best shoe for disco dancing, soccer, and hiking? Okay, if you chose number one for soccer, you are correct. Number two belongs with disco dancing. And number three is definitely a great shoe for hiking. Nice job, everyone. Okay, so moving on with our lesson today. Last week we focused mainly on inferences. This week we're going to focus on identifying cause and effect within a fiction text. So, what exactly is cause and effect? When you read, think about what happens and try to connect the different events of the story together. While you are doing this, you are actually determining the cause and effect. So a cause is why something happens, and the effect is what happens because of the cause. So it can get a little tricky. So again, a cause is why something happens, and an effect is what happens because of the cause. So let's take a look and get some practice. So we're going to think here for a minute. What are some possible causes and effects? So for the first example, we are given a cause. So Steve hit the baseball really far. So, because Steve hit the baseball really far, we want to think, what is the effect or what is the outcome of Steve hitting the baseball really far? So, I'm going to give you this first example of my thought process. Well, I know that I used to play softball and I've watched baseball. So, I know that usually if someone, the batter is up, and they're hitting the ball really far, that's a great opportunity for them to take advantage of getting a home run. So I'm hoping that for Steve, because he hit the ball really far, no one in the outfield is going to catch it, and he has the opportunity to get a home run. Because Steve hit the ball far. Okay, Steve got. A home. Run. And I apologize for my writing. This is not the easiest tool to write with. I thought there was a different text tool, but it doesn't look like it. So my apologies for my writing. Hopefully you are able to read it. But that would be my effect or my outcome to Steve hitting the baseball really far. Okay, so let me show you another example, this time with the effect given to me or the outcome given to me. So my effect is that feathers were everywhere. Uh-oh. So I'm starting with my outcome. Let's say I'm coming home to my house and I see that I have a pillow stuffed with feathers and the feathers are everywhere and my dog is out of his crate. Uh-oh. So feathers were everywhere and my cause is because my dog Bear was out of his crate. He was left alone and he chewed on my pillow. So Bear chewed my pillow, my feather top pillow. Because Bear was out of his crate and he chewed my pillows with my feathers, the feathers were everywhere. And I have learned my lesson that he needs to be in his crate. So, lesson learned. Okay, so what we're going to do is. Okay, so this. Is the cause column. So, because this happened, what is the outcome or what is the effect? All right, so I'm going to give you 2 minutes. I want you to think. You're given a cause and an effect. Your cause is Doug worked very hard in school. So, because he worked very hard in school, what would be a good effect? And then you're also given an effect. People got sick. Well, why did people get sick? So, take the next 2 minutes and you can think of your own effect and cause. Okay, so what I might say is because Doug worked very hard in school, An effect might be he received straight A's. Okay, that's his outcome for working very, very hard. If I'm given the effect that people got sick, the cause of it might be they didn't take proper safety precautions and didn't wash their hands. So, because they didn't wash their hands, the effect was they got sick. So, some more examples is I woke up late, so I missed the bus to school. Okay, so what would be the cause here? Because I woke up late, I missed the bus to school. Okay. Fred had to mop the floor because he spilled his juice. So, because he spilled his juice, the outcome or the effect was he had to mop the floor. When I walked in the rain, I got wet. Okay, so because I walked in the rain, the outcome or the effect is I got wet. Because the power was out for hours, what happened? What was the effect? The ice cream in the freezer melted. The door was left unlocked. Because the door was left unlocked, what was the effect? The thief broke into the house. I couldn't go out for recess because I forgot my homework. So my cause is I forgot my homework, and the effect or the outcome is I couldn't go out for recess. Mia's shoelaces were untied, so she tripped and fell. So, because her shoelaces were untied, she tripped and fell. And because Greg was hungry, the outcome or the effect was he ate a snack. Okay, just a few examples of our cause and effect. Because something happened, what is our effect? What is our outcome? Okay. And our example, they just did it vice versa. They underlined the cause and circled the effect, whereas we circled the cause and underlined the effect. Okay. So what we have here is a nonfiction passage, and I will read it. You can follow along. We are going to revisit it again in tomorrow's lesson, and we're going to answer some questions to go along with cause and effect tomorrow. But today I just wanted to introduce you to the story, and then tomorrow we will read it again, reread it, and use it to help us with some guiding questions. Okay? So today I'm going to read it aloud, and you can follow along as well, listen, and again, tomorrow we will use it for some guiding questions to go along with cause and effect. So the title of our story is called Gone. Wait until you see it. I'm really excited that we could come back with you guys, said my dad, taking his eyes briefly off the road to grin at my brother and I in the back seat. Why did you and Mom move away in the first place? I asked, pressing my head against the window of the car. Most of the trip had been on the highway's long, boring stretches of road, but now there was plenty to look at. The company my dad worked for was having their grand opening in the town he and my mother met and got married in. They insisted we all make the trip down. I got transferred to another store, but we enjoyed living here. The people were nice and friendly, and the town was small enough that everyone knew who you were. My brother, Ben, frowned. And you liked that? I think I prefer the city. I pointed to the old movie theater. You don't see buildings like that in the city. Thank goodness, Ben said. Mom shut the air conditioning off and rolled down her window. Breathe in some of the fresh country air. It's good for you. Ben and I rolled our windows down and pretended to choke when we breathed. Very funny, boys. But you won't be laughing when you see the park we got married in. It's a 30-acre forest with a man-made lake. There are even swans living in it. I shrugged my shoulders and continued staring out the window. Where are we going first, the park or the new store? Dad continued driving straight out of town. Both. Apparently, the company built the store next to the forest. A few minutes later, we came to a stop. Mom's gasp of dismay was the first clue something was wrong. Dad's intense shake of his head was the second. Alan, look what they did! I can't believe it! Mom opened the door the moment the car came to a stop. The store was one of the bigger ones I'd seen. It took up a lot of space. The bright neon sign, brick walls, and paved parking lot seemed a little out of place. Where's the park? I looked around for a lake or forest, but all I saw was the store and some empty fields. This is where the park was. We're standing where the forest was. Oh, Alan, the lake is gone. The swans. She stopped when tears filled her eyes. My dad looked just as upset. He walked to the side of the store. Ben and I followed him. Right about there was the lake. He pointed to a wet, mucky-looking area filled with broken bricks, wires, and random garbage. Mom came over. She wasn't crying anymore, but she still looked sad. Remember the turtles? I looked back and forth between my parents' grieved faces, then asked, What about the turtles? When your mom and I were in school, we studied the different ecosystems. We volunteered for an entire summer taking care of box turtles, recording their moves, tracking them, and watching their eggs. Why would you do that? Ben asked, looking at the mud like he might see a turtle now. The turtles are endangered, which means one day they might be extinct. Dad shook his head again. I can't believe I work for a company that would do this. I picked my way through the mud and garbage, trying to picture a lake and forest pretty enough that my parents would get married there. It was hard to do. The ugliness of the massive store was difficult to ignore. What happened to the turtles? I asked. They likely died. Mom reached for Dad's hand. I looked at Ben, who had stared back in horror. What? With their home gone, they either had to find a new one or they died. The turtles aren't the only animals. Think of the birds, the rodents, the fish. So many lost their homes. We stared at the store for a moment longer before getting back into the car. Dad no longer seemed interested in going inside. Mom talked about her memories of the forest, while Ben pulled out a piece of paper and drew a picture of a turtle. I just looked out of the window. I wondered how many more forests would be lost before someone did something. Okay, so that was our story. Again, tomorrow we're going to reread the passage. But for today, I just want you to think about the story, think about how it would relate to different scenarios of cause and effect. Because of this, what would be the outcome? Because of this happening, it caused this particular outcome to occur. Okay, so just think about those things in our story, and we'll have some guiding questions in tomorrow's lesson, and we'll think about that. So I just want to leave you with some writing that you can do independently. I just want to share this prompt with you. You can write a story where the main character falls down. Describe what could have caused it. Make sure that your story has characters, a setting, a problem, and a solution. Okay, so let's just go back and remember that cause is the why something is happening. And the effect is what happens because of the cause. So I like to think of the effect as the outcome. So why is something happening? And what is the outcome of the why? Okay, so I will leave you with this writing prompt. Feel free to write independently. I will leave this up for the next minute or two. Again, think about a main character falling down. What could have caused him to, him or her, to have fallen down? And your story can include characters, setting, a problem, and solution. So thank you for tuning in today. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And we will get some more practice with some cause and effect. Have a great day.